Welcome to Lowther Castle, 2022. That last building was the Countess's summer house. And this thing we're coming up to now is the Roman bath. This is the rock garden. Quite popular in 19th century gardens and beyond. This looks as if it used to be some kind of quite a nice pond, as you can see. Look carefully there, you can see where there would have been a fountain or something. This is at the top end of the rock garden. There's a little feature here known as the coffin, for obvious reasons. Through these little bits of woods here, we have something called the squirrel hide. Nice little wooden sculpture of a squirrel. If you can see just about. And there's the hide itself. This area is called the Japanese garden, but to be fair, it's not looking very Japanesey at the moment. But it looks like they've got some kind of planting plan that they're getting on with over the next couple of years, so should look better in a couple of years. Up here on our right, we've got another summer house, and this is the Rose Garden summer house, which sits next to the Rose Garden that we'll see in a minute. Let's have a look at this. This looks nice. The roof looks a bit Chinesey. Looks in decent nick. Assume it's locked at the moment. So the Rose Garden summer house gets its name from where it has a view of the very nice looking Rose Garden. So let's go and check out this Rose Garden. Lovely purple and white flowers. If we come through to the middle, a very nice fountain. near on the eastern terrace, there's another summer house called the Jubilee Summer House. Another couple of ex-ponds up here in an area marked down as the Iris Garden. Ruined little folly or shelter there. Here's the other unused pond. Further on through these woods, you've got a little calf that's not open today. Through the woods down there is children's play area called the Lost Castle, which looks like a castle made out of wood. Obviously I don't want to get too close filming kids or whatever, it's a bit dodgy. So there we go, leave it to the kids. Looks good though. Another thing to note, when you're walking across this western terrace at the edge of the gardens, which I mistakenly called the eastern terrace earlier, is the view is absolutely beautiful. Lots of these little shelters dotted around. Assume they used to have roofs on. This is the house from in the gardens. So this is the rear of the house. Here we have another summer house. This one's called Jack Croft's Summer House. In front of it is Jack Croft's pond. It's got a fair few reeds in it in the moment. You can see some water a bit further on down. Back to the summer house now. Yeah, so that was Lowther Castle in 2022. And I would say it's a really nice place to visit for, you know, half a day or something, well worth it if you're in the area. I mean, look how beautiful it looks. Thanks for watching.